look around your world today, every single product you interact with, from the bridges you cross to the shoes on your feet. Before they appeared in our world, they were first stirred in the soul of their creator. Creativity seeking expression, desire meeting design. Like a city skyline rising up on the horizon, form begins to take shape. Design defines the time. As a self-taught designer, you've built your hugely successful brand from the ground up, growing from a single item into a ready-to-wear empire. It all started with a black hat and a big dream 10 years ago. Take us back to where the magic began.
I think I was always trying to find a way to blend my creative background, that desire to put something together, but in a way that was marketable. Fashion seemed like a perfect place to fuse those things. And really for me, I think ignorance was bliss. I really had no technical background in fashion. Grew up in LA, you know, but I had grown up doing a lot of art. So I was painting, I was doing photography, and I wasn't sure where that would all lead me one day. But I graduated from UC Berkeley. I was traveling around in the Eurorail, going to all these different countries, and I was seeing all of these things that were really inspiring to me. And I was thinking, you know, how can I combine what I'm seeing there with this Southern California casual lifestyle that I was used to? And I figured, okay, I want to make this clothing line. I came back to LA, no clue how to get started. So I just bought a black hat that was already made, made a logo that said Rails, which reminded me of traveling around in the Eurorail. Sewed it on the hat, started walking around to stores, asking people if they wanted to buy this one hat that I had. And everybody was rejecting me. They're like, you can't just walk into a store with a single hat. So I had a friend who was working at Fred Segal, which is a great boutique in LA. And I said, just put it on the counter on consignment. If you sell it, you can pay me. If not, I'll come take it back. So they put out a few hats and people started buying them. And so for about 2-3 months, I was just feeding them these hats with my logo on it. And they said, okay, I need to start expanding. So I made this one zip up hooded sweatshirt, garment dyed it, and everything came out twisted. The zipper was off to the side, total disaster. And I thought I was out of business. And everybody said, this is the coolest hoodie we've ever seen. You know, did you deliberately make it twisted like that? And people started buying them. Matthew McConaughey came, bought 10 of them for his friends for the holidays. So I said, okay, I have something here with my hat and my hoodie. I'm not sure what's happening, but I'm gonna go on the road and drive all over the US. I was just walking into stores unannounced, trying to build the brand. Going around to stores for 2-3 months and getting rejected by a lot of people, it was a humbling experience, but it also drove me.
What I love about your story is that you wouldn't take no for an answer. What were some of your biggest challenges and how did you overcome them?
I think a lot of this experience has been a journey of self-discovery for me, and I had a lot of resolve. Just because somebody told me no, that wasn't the end of the story. I knew, okay, to really build a brand, I need to focus in a certain area. So I really settled in the shirting category, which I knew was a classic style that I could repeat season after season, but I knew I needed to do something special. So I made a fabric that at the time nobody was making. Early days, people were making a lot of these button-down shirts and cotton, a little bit more rigid fabric, and I made a different fabric made out of Tencel rayon, which almost felt like cashmere. So it was very much trial and error in the early days. We were tinkering with different constructions. Our first run of production, and by our, I mean mine plus the factory who is helping me to make the garments, we made 2,000 units of an order. And we went through the whole production cycle. We were about to ship it, and the factory called me and they said, hey, we have a problem. The fabric shrunk differently on the inside and the outside. You could see every 1 inch, there was a looping to connect the two fabrics, and you could see through all these little dots to the back of the fabric. I said, we don't know how to solve it. What we ended up having to do was we brought in like 100 people, each with an inkwell and a paintbrush, and every single 1 inch with a little dot of ink to block the little holes, and turned out to be a bestseller. Nobody recognized it, and it was our first trial, and everybody loved the hand feel. They didn't care about this effort that we had to put in behind the scenes. And so there's all these things in the fashion business that the customer doesn't see, but you have to solve your way through and be clever and creative, and we still delivered a great product that people love. That's part of, I think, why we've been successful, is not getting bogged down by problems that come our way, but really trying to figure out how do we solve them and move forward.
Despite so many crushing obstacles, you never seemed to doubt that one day your company would become this global success. Who was your first big order from, and how did that moment feel?
So I don't want it to seem that, you know, our business has been this comedy of errors, because I think many businesses behind the scenes, there's always problem solving. But, you know, the first big order that I had was a really great store in the US. It was for about 2,000 plaid button-down shirts. I made them in Los Angeles. I was working by myself. I had no employees. And it took me about 2-3 months to make the order. I packed all the boxes myself. I put all the stickers on them. You know, 18-wheel truck comes and picks it up. I was so excited that night. It was like a $100,000 order. I was celebrating, and I woke up the next morning, and the trucking company called me and said, hey, sorry to let you know, but the truck was robbed right after we picked up your goods, and we don't know where they are. And I was thinking, wait a second, that's impossible. Like, you have to be able to find my products. It took me 2 months to make those. They ended up never finding them. It took me about 6 to 8 months to get paid by the insurance. I wasn't able to ship the goods again to that store. And, you know, that was something that I think could have put a lot of people out of business. But I sort of regrouped. I was working by myself. I had very little overhead. I scrapped my way through it and figured out how to, okay, keep moving forward.
Gotta keep pushing, yeah. Ready or not.
Well, as a testament to your unrelenting positivity, since then you've built Rails into a ready-to-wear empire. What do you think separates your brand from all the rest?
I think in anything, there's really no blueprint to creating a successful fashion brand. You have to trust your creative instincts. You can't try to be everything to everyone. We've had a lot of success over the years, and I think first and foremost, it's because we focus on product. Starting with the fabric that we innovated in the early days, that really has carried over into all the categories that we've introduced. So whether it's shirting or jersey knits, sweaters, outerwear, dresses, we always try to focus on super soft hand feel. And I think our customer recognizes that as unique to our brand. And I think building an emotional connection with the customer has been super important for our brand, and not just with the customer, but again, with our business and people who are working at Rails. We've had people who've been in-house with us for over 10 years. I think this sort of builds this ecosystem of love for our product and our brand, and that's helped bring us to where we are today. And then we've also been very fortunate from the early days to have so many celebrities wearing our product because it opened us to this global platform. I've spent a lot of time traveling to international markets to build them on a grassroots level, much like we built the US business. So really understanding who the customers are in each of these locations, what are the currencies that we're dealing with, are there import restrictions, the technical back end side, and figuring out how do you put all of those things together to build a really robust international business. And I don't think a lot of LA brands are thinking of themselves in that way. We've really dedicated ourselves to doing that.
When you look back at your extraordinary journey, what is the one thing that you're most proud of?
You know, it's interesting to look back and think I just started with a single hat and $5,000 that I had saved up. And, you know, to date, we've done more than $350 million at retail. We're selling in about 50 countries, 1,500 stores. I think I'm most proud of having come really from nowhere, no technical background, no understanding of what I was supposed to do, and navigating our way through this challenging environment and 10 years later having this really successful brand. And I'm also very proud of the people who've done it with me along the way. I just enjoy the challenge of every day waking up, creating something from nothing, building something, problem solving, and just creating. The idea of creation to me is the most important thing. Of course, the financial success is a great byproduct of that, but that's not what drives me. I think the journey is the exciting part about this business. There's no end goal. I don't think I'm gonna reach a point where I said, I've done it, and be finished. The journey is what's amazing about this, and creating and innovating, and every season there's some new challenge and reinventing yourself. That's what I love about the business, and I think that's why we're being successful.
Powerful reminder, it's not the destination we seek, but the joy of the journey. Designing, creating, innovating, these are not exclusive to a chosen few. If we're willing to dig deep, they're an unstoppable force within us all. Unstoppable.